raining outside now, and I'm having a cup of coffee and curious about the behavior of our nature. Meet these gentlemen, Mallikarjun and Nagabhushan. Both of them lives in Bangalore and a very close friend of mine. These two gentlemen also have a curiosity about nature too. They often come up with so many questions about nature like kids and keep on thinking on those unresolved answers. And they have requested me to make a video on their choices of three topics. The origin of life, Big Bang theory. Why does thunderstorm happen? Where does the air come from? This is the perfect day to respect their request to me. This video is dedicated to Mallikarjun and Nagabhushan as a gesture of their love and trust in me. Friends, this video is also for you who loves nature and are curious about the wonders of nature the same way as I do. How old is the universe and how did it begin? Throughout the research history, countless myths, hypotheses, and scientific theories have tried to explain the universe's origin. The most extensively accepted simplification is the Big Bang theory. In 1927, the Belgian Catholic priest Georges Lemaître proposed an expanding model for the universe to explain the observed redshifts of spiral nebulae. He based his theory on the work of Einstein and De Sitter and independently derived Friedmann's equation for an expanding universe. In the very beginning of Earth's history, this planet was a giant, red-hot, roiling, boiling sea of oceans of magma. The heat had been generated by the repeated high-speed collisions of much smaller bodies of space rocks that continually stumped together as they collided to form our current planet. As the collisions gradually decreased, the primitive Earth began to cool, forming a thin crust on its surface. As the cooling continued, water vapor began to escape and condense on the Earth's early atmosphere. Cloud formed and storms raged, raining more and more water down on the primitive Earth, cooling the surface further until it was flooded with water, forming the seas. Scientists are still trying to resolve one of the greatest mysteries of Earth. When did life first appear and how did it happen? It is estimated that the first life forms on Earth were primitive, one-celled creatures that appeared about 3 billion years ago. Then suddenly those single-celled organisms began to evolve into multicellular organisms. Then an unparalleled profusion of life in incredibly complex forms began to fill the oceans. The Miller-Urey experiment was a chemical experiment that stimulated the condition at the time to be present on the early Earth and tested the chemical origin of life under those conditions. The experiment used water, methane, ammonia, and hydrogen. The chemicals were all sealed inside a sterile 5-liter glass flask connected to a 500 ml flask half full of water. Then by going through a stage of evaporation, continuous electrical spark and condensation, they have simulated lightning in the water vapor and gaseous mixture condition like primitive earth. At the end of 1 week of continuous operation and processing, through a series of chemical reactions, Miller identified 5 amino acids present in the solutions. Amino acid, the first building block of life in this earth. Still, scientists are finding new indications to find out how life first began on Earth in some really interesting places, the deep ocean. It's the Earth where we live in, and the life on Earth swims at the bottom of a colorless ocean of air. The presence of air on our beautiful planet Earth began before the planet even formed. During the Big Bang, various gases such as helium, oxygen, and others were together, which were distributed to its part when that big ball of heat broke up. Fortunately, our Earth got a major part of the surviving gas oxygen. Volcanic eruptions also gave these gases, which occurred very frequently in those historic times. This formed the base of atmosphere. Earth's current atmosphere developed through a sequence of events that started with the coalescing solar system. Air is the invisible mixture of gases that surrounds the Earth. Air contains important substances such as oxygen, nitrogen, and most species need it to survive. The wind is air in motion. It's produced by the uneven heating of the Earth's surface by the sun. Some part of the earth receive direct rays from the sun all the year and are always warm. Other places receive indirect rays, so the climate is colder. Warm air, which weighs less than cold air, rises up. Then cool air moves in and replaces the rising warm air. This movement of air is what makes the wind to blow. Sea has a greater heat absorbing capacity than land. So the surface of the sea warms up more slowly than the land. The warming air expands and becomes less dense, decreasing the pressure over the land. The air above the sea has a relatively higher pressure, causing air near the coast to flow towards the lower pressure over land. At night, the land cools off faster than the ocean due to differences in their heat capacity. If the land becomes cooler than the adjacent sea surface temperature, the air pressure over the water will be lower than that of the land, setting up a land breeze blowing from the land to sea. The land breeze will die once the land warms up again in the next morning. Thunder is a sound caused by lightning and depends on the distance and the nature of the lightning. The sudden increase in pressure and temperature from lightning produces rapid expansion of air within and surrounding the path of a lightning strike. In turn, this expansion of air creates a sonic wave, often referred to as a thunderclap or peal of thunder. Storm. Lightning is an electric current within a cloud way up in the sky. Many small pieces of frozen raindrops bumps into each other as they move around in the air. All of those collisions create an electric charge. After a while, the whole cloud fills up with electrical charges. The positive charges or protons form at the top of the cloud, and the negative charges or electrons form at the bottom of the cloud. Since opposites attract, that causes a positive charge to build up on the ground beneath the cloud. The ground electrical charge concentrates around anything that sticks up, such as mountains, people, or single trees. Lightning is approximately 54,000 degrees of Fahrenheit. That is 6 times hotter than the surface of the sun. Thunderstorms occur in a type of cloud known as cumulonimbus. They are usually accompanied by strong winds and often produce heavy rain and sometimes snow, sleets, or hail. Strong or severe thunderstorms include some of the most dangerous weather phenomena, including large hails, strong winds, and tornadoes. Thunderstorms can form and develop in any geographic location, but most frequently within the mid-latitude, where hot, moist air from tropical latitudes collides with cooler air from polar latitudes. Thunderstorms are responsible for the development and formation of many severe weather phenomena.